Hey guys, how are you doing? And in this episode, we are going to see how to install and remove iOS 17 developer beta or public beta version on your iPhone or iPad. In Settings, General, Software Update section, by default, we were seeing Automatic Updates option only. After updating to 16.5, you will also see the Beta Updates section. You can choose which beta testing program you want to participate. Right now, Apple have opened the developer beta version for everyone. Previously, we were installing the beta profile, either it is public beta or developer beta, manually by downloading from either Apple website or third-party website. But right now, they have made it so much easier and no more profiles involved. You simply have to select that setting in order to use it. And in this page, you can see the available developer beta and public beta versions. And the iOS 17 developer preview is the only one that is released recently by Apple. And only next month, we will see the iOS 17 public beta. And right now, you can see the 16 public beta and developer beta versions are currently available. If you select that, then you will be receiving the 16.6 as of today. And here, I have selected iOS 17 developer beta. And in the previous page, it'll automatically refresh and the 17 developer beta download will be readily available. This page may take a couple of seconds extra time, show you the available updates, and make sure you connect to Wi-Fi if there is any problem with the mobile data. And to remove the installation of developer beta without any data loss, I have already published a video in our channel. I'll leave a link to that in the description and in the first comment, because even though iOS 17 developer beta first version have so much positive reviews when it comes to the app compatibility, still there is a problem with the features Apple have announced, that most of the features are not working. We often encounter some bugs related to blank pages and a few crashes here and there. So if you decided to move to the stable version of iOS 16.5 or whatever the stable option available, you can use the suggested method to downgrade without any data loss. Thanks for watching, and I hope you found this video useful. Don't forget to subscribe for more useful iPhone, iPad, and Mac related tips and tricks. Thank you and have a wonderful day.